Good morning, church family. Happy Sabbath. We're going to start out our service by singing, I Love You, Lord. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord hath made.
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord hath made, that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice, we will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord hath made, that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice, we will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord hath made.
Thank you, everyone. That was beautiful singing.
Good morning, church family.
Good morning, everyone.
So glad to see
Happy
these kids
Sabbath.
Here.
Yes,
wow.
Don't they look awesome? You know what? I understand that there are some relatives here. Yes?
At least
I know of at least a grandma and grandpa.
We have a grandma.
I even know their name.
We have a couple grandma and grandpas here and some aunts and uncles to hear these kids sing. So we're so glad.
So I hear buttons popping already, and they haven't even performed yet. So Melissa, we're just delighted to have you and your choir and the bells with us today. What a wonderful way to celebrate Sabbath and worship Jesus on a day when the world, Christian world, celebrates Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection. And we celebrate that. I tell people we celebrate that all year long.
Amen.
Because it's not just a one-day event, it's a life-changing event. So I took some of your time. I'm sorry.
That's fine. I'm used to it.
Whoa, did you hear that? Oh.
Well, we are such a happy church, and we're so glad you're here. If there's something you would like to ask the pastoral team or have special prayer for, use the welcome card that's in front of you and drop it and fill it out, drop it in the offering plate, and we'll be glad to call you during the week. So please let us know if you need something. And we're so glad, of course, that the Campion is here and all the kids. It's great. We have a second reading today, Pastor.
We do. So this is how you help our church grow. So George and Lana, where are they? There I see them sitting back there. Why don't you, do you mind standing up? And their beautiful family. And is there a motion to accept their transfer? Second. All those in favor from Camarillo, welcome them home. And if you want to join them, just pull that card out of the pew in front of you, fill it out, drop it in the offering plate, or give it to Pastor Will or myself, or drop it in the treasure box there in the lobby. And you can also include your prayer praises and requests, and that way we can make sure and get them included in our weekly updates to all of our church family. So another thing that's happening soon is a birthday.
Mine?
No. No. You wouldn't let me say anything about yours.
Oh, no.
That was March 17. So we're a little past that, but who's, yeah, anyway. No. This is a special one. It's a 50th birthday.
Okay. Who wants to own up to that?
The little guy sitting up here in front. Wave. Come on, Dave. Stand up so they can see you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear David. Happy birthday to you. I think you have some more announcements.
I know. We need Colleen. Where's Colleen? We have something going on tonight.
Where is Colleen?
And we want Colleen to tell us.
Yes.
Well, tonight we have our family Vespers, so we hope to see each one of you there. Bring something for a light vegetarian supper, and I know for sure that we had wonderful lentil soup last night, so we'll be putting out some more of that lentil soup tonight, which is delicious. If you missed that Vespers last night, you missed a wonderful time together with communion. But come out tonight. It's going to start at 6 o'clock. I know that in our past bulletin it said 5, but it's actually going to start at 6 o'clock tonight. And then after our supper and our worship, we're going to be watching a movie. And it has to do with the story of Hosea and the guy weaving that into Bible times and real time. So it'll be a great family movie for everyone to enjoy tonight.
Thank you. Hope to see you there tonight. And yes, communion last night was really special.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
It was the Agape Supper and just spending time acknowledging the Lord. We have about 75 of you that joined us last night. It was wonderful. It's very special. Now, you have more on your calendar, don't you?
Well, there's just a few calendar items we want to bring to you. On Monday night will be the men's ministry. They come to the church and get together, and we invite the men to come and do that. So it's at 7 o'clock on this Monday night. And I think you do it twice a month?
Yes.
Is it? Twice a month, okay. And then I think on Tuesday night, we have a pre-constituency meeting here, so tell us about that.
All right, you all, how many Camarillo church members or people from Ventura County, actually, raise your hands. All right, I've just taken a picture. You all need to be here. After all, you want to know what's happening in your conference, don't you? There's going to be some personnel changes. You'll need to be aware of those. There's some bylaws that are going to be tweaked a little bit. Nothing major, but that's what we do at constituency time. And so I would encourage not only the delegates that are your church has chosen to represent you at the constituency meeting, but all church members to come and hear what's happening in our conference. Good things are going on, so plan on being here Tuesday night at 7 for that important meeting.
Now we have something from Linda Vista, our elementary school, and Principal Sharon.
Yes.
Well, we have our annual visitation night on Thursday night. We're doing it in the evening this year. And it'll start at 6:30, going from 6:30 to 8:30. We're going to have some fun things, some open rooms there, and the kids are going to have a passport book to go from room to room. We have a lot of things going on at Linda Vista. It is your school, and we encourage you to even just come out and hang out and just check it out and see what's going on. We have strong academics. We have a National Junior Honor Society. We have music that starts in kindergarten and goes all the way through eighth grade, several different venues. We have bells, and we have recorders, and we have audition choir, and we have school choir, and we have beginning band, and we have advanced band. And so we have plenty of music. We have art classes that we enter four different contests a year for our art students. We have a fabulous new learning garden that we are developing on 3 acres of land. And we will be putting up the outdoor learning pavilion here in the next couple of weeks. We have all the permits for that now so that we can hold outdoor classrooms, outdoor classes in our garden there. So we're looking forward to that. So come out and check us out. And we have refreshments. And you're welcome to just come out for a little bit and see what's going on at your school.
Sharon, before you leave, on April 13, can you help us on the constituents, Linda Vista?
Good idea. April 13th is the annual constituency meeting. That is where you come and you find out what has gone on in the past year, what are some of the significant issues we are dealing with at Linda Vista, that we need some of your help. We actually have lots of good things going, and about the only thing we need is enrollment. But that's okay. God's got that in his hand. He's going to lead us on that. So come on out. That's the constituency is Monday night at 7 o'clock.
April 13th.
A week from Monday.
A week from this Monday. So please put that on your calendar. That's much appreciated. Very, very much. By the way, Newberry Park Adventist Academy. How many academy students do we have here today from Newberry Park? All right, I see. Where's Travis? Did I miss Travis? Anyway, that's okay. But on April 10 at 8 o'clock in the morning, come on up. This is Andre.
You see, he didn't even ask. Hello. And he came on up to share with you, so that's great.
Well, Newberry Park Adventist Academy is having this Friday a passion play, an annual thing that the entire junior class is in charge of. And it's a wonderful program where you can come out. The bulletin insert is wrong. It's actually going to be 11 o'clock in the morning and not 8 o'clock. And then in the evening program is going to be at 7. So if you want to come out for that, it's going to be $5 per person. Academy students can come in for free. But it's a lovely program. It displays the entire Great Controversy story, and it's a great, great thing to come out and support the Newberry.
Okay, those times again. Get your bulletin out. Make a note. 11 o'clock and 7. It says 8 and 8 in your bulletin. So 11 o'clock and 7. Got it? Good. Awesome, and you will not want to miss this. They do such a fabulous job with that. And also on April 10 is the Jeff Gaines Golf Tournament for those golfers in our group. It's an opportunity to raise money for our needy cause, the Jeff Gaines Fund at our school. So thank you for supporting Christian education and our sister schools around the globe. Just thrilling to have them here and they're leading us in worship this morning, so it's really exciting. I'm going to invite the congregation to stand for prayer, please. Loving Jesus, we want you to know how privileged we are to have you front and center in our service today. Jesus, we are here as your servants to serve you. You have talent galore in this congregation today. But you have blessed these young people with voices and with musical talents and gifts. And you are going to be there with them, filling in every sound and allowing it to be just amazing today. bless each one that has a part in our service today, that we will give you glory and honor and praise always. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. Isn't that beautiful? I was going to invite you to kneel with me, and I will do that. But how many of you have a special prayer request today? Something going on in your life that you want help with, or family members help and need? We're a praying church, and we make no apologies for that. But that's what a privilege it is for us to kneel before the throne of grace and ask Jesus to bless us. We've experienced healings, we've experienced sadness, we've experienced blessings, we've experienced God's richest outpouring of His Spirit, and we want that to continue, and how that continues is by our connection with Him on a daily basis. So as we come together as a family of God, I invite you as far as possible to kneel with me as prayer. You all may kneel if you wish, or you may just stay seated. Glorious Father, this morning you have us on your mind. This is an exciting day in your world because your church family around the globe. Different time zones, yes, but your family comes to worship you on Sabbath morning. And so it's a special time. So my plea with you this morning is that the windows to heaven are opened wide, and you, Father, and you, Jesus, are sitting there. And through the power of your Holy Spirit, you're with us today. You're right here in the very presence of us. Your angels are bowing their heads and taking our prayers, those silent ones that are being shared to, spoken to you right now, are being carried by them to you, Jesus. And you are taking our prayers and then filling in all of the details that need to be filled in and presenting them to the Father in perfect, in with perfection and clarity. And so we want to give you honor and praise this morning and gratitude for all of the work that you're doing and the many answers that we have seen to our requests. This morning, we've already asked for your powerful presence here, but not just to be with us for an hour or so, but we want this to be a lifelong experience. And so as we leave here today, that our hearts, our minds will be full of your glorious knowledge and grace and power. The melodies that we're going to be hearing today and the words from the songs that we're going to be listening to will be forever remembered as we all day long, each day of the week, give you honor and praise and glory. And so we thank you for this privilege we have today to kneel before you and thank you for the gift of eternal life, the greatest gift ever. You have risen indeed and made that possible for us. And so we praise you and thank you for that wonderful and life-changing gift, the gift of eternal life. May all of us today embrace it and accept it and live it each and every day, is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's stand and sing our opening hymn, Jesus is Coming Again, hymn number 213.
This church has a lot of vision, a lot of programs and a lot of things that we're doing to try and make us noticeable to our community and bring new people into the church. Today's offering is for church budget. I wanted to say, you know, we've paid for a lot of things that we've redone in this church. But one of the things that has been one of my most favorite things to see is the stained glass window behind me. And I don't know how thick I am, but it took me almost 2 years to realize the three-dimensional architecture in that stained glass window. And it was one day I just was kind of gazing into it, and I realized the depth of what it was saying. So if the deacons will please stand, and will you bow your heads with me as we ask God to bless us. Gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for all the wonderful blessings that you give. Let us not miss any of them. Let us know each and every one and feel the depth in them and see the vision that they can provide for us. We ask, Lord, that you bless this offering, bless this congregation, bless these students who have traveled to share with us their message. These things I ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Oh, happy Sabbath, everyone. Hope you're enjoying your Easter weekend. Our scripture today comes from Acts 4, 32 and 33. I'll give you a few minutes to find that. Acts 4, 32 and 33. And it says, "All the believers were one in heart and mind. No one claimed that any of their possessions was their own, but they shared everything they had. With great power, the apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and God's grace was so powerfully at work in them all. Now I invite you all, those who are able, to please kneel with me for prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us another Sabbath. Thank you for allowing us to live in a country where we can freely worship you. Father, today, as this weekend, as we're remembering the great sacrifice that you gave for us, help us to truly remember what that means, and as we go through our week, help us to think more and more of you, and please help us to be blessed from this service today, and help us and draw us closer to you. In your name, amen.
Good morning and happy Sabbath. We are delighted to be here with you this morning and worshiping with you through music. The bells will play a very familiar tune from our hymnal that you will recognize, I'm sure, arranged by Kathy Mokelbust. Let all mortal flesh keep silence. The text for that first piece, sung in Latin, was "Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations." We will next share with you an arrangement of an American folk hymn entitled "My Shepherd Will Supply My Need," which is based on the 23rd Psalm.
Thank you.
Isn't that beautiful? Wow. Now is the time when you can have a part in the program, but I have a little bit of history I want to share with you before I say anything further. We have a grandmother of one of our students whose grandfather was the first principal of Campion Academy back in 1907. How about a little bit of Adventist history? Not only that, but in the first graduating class of Campion Academy was a gentleman by the name of HMS Richards. How many of you know him? If you're Seventh-day Adventist, you know HMS Richards. He used to be our neighbor. And what is it about Colorado taking all of our good people? Anyway, I digress. So if I'm counting correctly, your grandson would be the fifth generation. Did I count that right? I usually get my numbers mixed up, but I think I got that one right. Isn't that cool? And I think he's standing right over there. Wave high. Come on. Because we've got to, in that, what a legacy. So you've got big shoes to fill. So you're doing a great job of it. Thank you so much. Well, you know, trips of this nature are costly. And have you been blessed today? And would you consider digging deep into your pocket and pulling out a $50 or $100 bill? And I have a $5, because remember, I'm your pastor. I'm going to invite the deacons to come forward, and as they're taking up a love offering, we will hear more from our fabulous guests today and blessing us with their wonderful music. Thank you.
I don't know if you recognize the tune for that last piece, but that's an African-American spiritual entitled Wade in the Water. And I was reading about Harriet Tubman during the time of the slaves escaping. She would call and sing that song to remind people to maybe go into the river and walk through the river as they were escaping to get around people looking for them. So I believe I can relate that obviously to our lives as Christians, and God will help us wade through the water and go through our trials in our lives. The next two pieces we will do as a set, and the first piece reminds us that we have a hope. The recent events, as I know you've seen on the news with the massacre in Kenya and that very sad story, reminds us that we, because of sin, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. And this piece is entitled, It Is Not Death to Die. We have a hope. We can look forward to that hope, and Jesus will come take us home. And then the second piece with that is a piece entitled None Other Lamb, and I wanted to read to you the text written by Christina Rossetti. It says, None other lamb, none other name, none other hope in heaven or earth or sea, none other hiding place from guilt and shame, none beside thee. My faith burns low, my hope burns low, only my heart's desire cries out in me by the deep thunder of its want and woe, cries out to thee. Lord, thou art life, though I be dead. Love's fire thou art, however cold I be. Nor heaven have I, nor place to lay my head. Nor home, nor home, but thee.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We will end with a piece, a fun spiritual that says, "I know the Lord will make a way. If you trust and never doubt, he will bring you out." Our soloist is Senior Brenda Maldonado.
Thank you so much. And church family, what do you know?
He'll make a way.
After all of that, church family, what do you know? The Lord will make a way. Isn't that wonderful? Thank you so much for blessing us. What a way to kick off spring. And we just are praying for traveling mercies with you as you hurry home tomorrow. It's a one-day trip, right? You've got three bus drivers, right? Oh, two. Okay. I feel better already. Anyway, that's good. That's a long drive for one. So blessings to you. Thank you for blessing us today, and you're in our prayers as you continue your ministry back in Colorado. Send give our love and regards to all of our family that's in Colorado. We are now have a bedroom community in Colorado, correct? So give them all a big hug for us. Tell them they don't know what they're missing, but they have you, so that's good. Thank you so much. My dear friends, let's stand for the closing prayer, please. Loving Heavenly Father, we come to you again on this, your Sabbath day, praising you and thanking you for telling us the way. And that is the way, because you are the way, the truth, and the life. And so we take you with us today. We leave here today with a song in our heart, and we'll be sharing the message that we've heard today every day with our friends, neighbors, and loved ones. So bless us immensely. Give traveling mercies to the Campion Choir and team as they return home. And bless all of us richly and beyond our wildest imaginations. In Jesus' name, amen.